Eurogold is driven by being the best civil engineering contractor in the Northwest, ensuring its clients are given the highest level of service that they deserve. Eurogold work in a wide range of industry sectors, including house building, highways, commercial and industrial build.
Lolavita is an award-winning, independently run Italian restaurant. Located on Rose Lane in the heart of Liverpool, real Italian-style dishes, using the best ingredients, skillfully prepared by our chefs. Come and try our serious Italian experience.
Supreme Upholstery Limited is a manufacturer of quality bespoke upholstered furniture. Come along with your ideas for that perfect sofa to fit your home and let Supreme bring your ideas to fruition. We also offer a service to the contract market, including large hotel groups and small family-run business. No matter how large or how small your order, you will always get that personal service from our sales team. Come along and visit our showroom.
Welcome to the Irish in the UK. This week we'll be finding out a little bit more about haemochromatosis. We'll be speaking to Dr. Rachel Brown at Trafford General Hospital in Greater Manchester. But first, Young Gifted and Green was formed 25 years ago by Tony Hennigan. It featured a young group of students from St. Bede's College in Manchester who was highly talented in music, song and dance. Well, recently, they organised a big concert at St. Bede's to celebrate the 25 years. Tony, here we are celebrating 25 years of Young Gifted and Green. Now tell me a little bit about how much money have you raised for charities over the year?
So far we've raised £210,000 over the 25 years for different charities. All our shows have been sellouts and the Irish community have got right behind us in sponsoring each and every one of our events so that all the money that we raise on the night goes directly to the charity. When we did the Bridgewater Hall show, it cost us £18,500 to stage that show. And every single penny of the £18,500 was raised by the Irish community so that all the ticket sales could be given directly to Rainbow Family Trust.
Now, Saturday night, of course, is a very big night. You're celebrating 25 years. You have got a wonderful lineup of talent performing for us all, but you've also got the Ganley sisters flying over from Ireland. How did you manage that?
Well, the Ganley sisters are part of the Mayo Manchester Trad Fest, which takes place in the summer every year. And Mayo.ie brought them over for us, especially to promote Mayo Day, which happens every year the first Saturday in May, right away throughout the world, and they brought them over here to promote Mayo in the west of Ireland. They're two fantastic dancers, award-winning dancers, who've been on RTE TV, and they're going to be performing here on Saturday night and taking part in a workshop on Sunday at St. Kent's.
Now, I believe that St. Pete's College is going to be bathed in green on Saturday night. Why is that?
Well, for the first time in its history, since 1876, we've managed to turn the college green as part of the worldwide global greening campaign from Tourism Ireland. Tourism Ireland have joined forces with us again this year to promote the global greening campaign, and the college will be bathed in emerald green to kickstart this year's 25th Manchester Irish Festival. It's going to be turned green on the night of the concert and again on St Patrick's Day itself.
Now, I know you've got a big star flying in specially to open the show on Saturday night. That's James Keegan from Lord of the Dance.
Indeed, we are extremely pleased about James, who starred in the first show in 1995, to be able to fly back in from Germany while he's on tour to perform at the show. It's fantastic of him to give up his time and his energy to take part in officially opening up the show, and we might even have a surprise appearance by him.
So, James, tell me, when did you get involved with Young, Gifted and Green?
Well, I guess it's right back towards the beginning. 25 years ago, Louise, as you know, my sister Louise, was at, I think she was in the high school, St. Bede's College at the time. Yeah. I was still in the prep school, and Tony Hennigan got things rolling with dancers, musicians and singers, and yeah, that was my first go at it.
Of course, I know that Tony Hennigan was involved in all things Irish at that particular time, indeed still is. I know he was a big influence on Louise and yourself in joining Young, Gifted and Green.
Of course, yeah, massive influence on us as children, and what he was doing as a teacher at St. Bede's. But then getting Young, Gifted and Green together, just what a great initiative and a great thing to be a part of as a young child. Going down to the Manchester Arndale every Saturday, we had the charity buckets out, and just performing what we could do. That's how it started. It was if you could sing, dance, whatever, just get up there and make a showpiece. Yeah, all credit to Tony Hennigan for getting it together and inspiring us all, really.
And of course, you appeared on great big shows then, didn't you? Like Blue Peter, and
yeah,
you performed at many, many big like theatres and that, so on.
That's right, yeah. I mean, of course, the news channel started to pick it up, Granada Reports and Northwest Tonight, Blue Peter. Yeah. I think we were on Blue Peter a couple of times, which is, as you know, huge.
Songs of Praise.
Songs of Praise is another one. Yeah. So yeah, there was not only great demand here in Manchester, but people really caught on to what we were doing and starting to raise good money as well. That was the most important thing.
What a night Saturday night is going to be, back at St. Bede's College as well.
I think it'd be more like a reunion as well. Yeah. Like I said, it's been great looking back on the social media platforms of the old faces, the old memories of Blue Peter or performance Songs of Praise. The Bridgewater Hall in Manchester was one of the highlights. 2,000 people, sold out show. It was incredible for a crowd of youngsters getting together, putting on a show.
Now, tell me a little bit about James Keegan himself and Lord of the Dance. We know that you're here on a flying visit today.
Yeah, flying visit as always. I'm just out on, back and forth of a tour at the moment in Germany. I just recently came back from China and Mexico. So I had a busy couple of months. Obviously here tonight, some of our children preparing for the World Championships in Dublin in April. And we teach from about 3 years, 3 years up, three and a half, we say, up to, I think our oldest pupil is about 18 at the moment. So yeah, all age groups, all levels, from the young, tiny beginners who've never done it before, and some of the more advanced guys behind us going through their drills. It's a real good kind of family feel class. Like they're all the children are great friends and the parents. We've lots of family nights and fundraising for some of these events they're going to, like the World Championships, and fundraising for dresses and the cost of travelling. So it brings everyone together, and it's like it's our own community here as well. You know, it's nice. And here at the Chorlton Irish Club, where Louise and I started dancing, it's nice to carry that on.
I was born despite the accent in Cork City, and my older brother is also from Cork City, as was my mother, and my father is from Limerick City.
Can you tell me a little bit about St. Bede's College here in Manchester?
St. Bede's College has actually been in existence since 1876, so very soon we'll be celebrating our 150th anniversary.
You must be very proud, of course, of the college.
We're extremely proud here at St. Bede's College of being able to host over so many years the fantastic Young Gifted and Green Festival, and we're very much looking forward on Saturday evening to host the 25th. I think the Irish history of the college is well known, and we're extremely proud of our Irish roots. So YGG and St. Bede's College and the history of the Irish people here in Manchester all go well together.
Tara, tell me, where did you learn that song from?
Well, last year we had a play and we had to learn that song. So we had to learn it from that week to the next. And then I knew it all the words the next day. I just loved that song. It was my favourite song.
Now, have you been practising that with your mum and dad? And will they be here on Saturday night watching you?
I have been practising it with my mum and dad, and they would not miss it for the world.
For Delma, the excitement is building. Really looking forward to Saturday night.
Oh, it's going to be amazing. What a great job Tony's done, the whole team. It's going to be incredible, and all for an incredible cause.
Yeah, and of course you've played with Young Gifted and Green for quite a long time.
Yeah, I have been since I was a youngster with Raid, Tell Shake the Barley formed. It's incredible. And the 25th anniversary as well. It's just amazing.
Martha, of course, you've played with Young Gifted and Green quite a bit as well.
Yeah, so I played one concert here when I was in first year, so year seven at the school, and then I played year eight at the Lowry in Manchester, and then I'm back here in my final year to play again at Beeds. I'm really looking forward to it.
Have you made many friends over the years with the, you know, the cast from Young Gifted and Green?
Yeah, I've made loads of new friends my age as well, so we go over to the Flowers together and everything. We all met doing YGG, so it's a really good way to meet loads of new people in Manchester playing music with all the youngsters.
What a great night, and what a wonderful group of talented people. And it was a special night for St. Bede's College in Manchester. Now, we're going to take a little break. In part two, we'll be finding out a little bit more about haemochromatosis.
Eurogold is driven by being the best civil engineering contractor in the Northwest, ensuring its clients are given the highest level of service that they deserve. Eurogold work in a wide range of industry sectors, including house building, highways, commercial and industrial build.
IJK's Scrap Metal, Manchester. We provide payment for scrap metal, removal and disposal of cars and abandoned vehicles, a weighbridge facility, authorised treatment facility, recycling and waste management. Full compliance with all legal requirements. IJK Scrap Metal, Manchester, a friendly, professional and reliable service.
Supreme Upholstery Limited is a manufacturer of quality bespoke upholstered furniture. Come along with your ideas for that perfect sofa to fit your home and let Supreme bring your ideas to fruition. We also offer a service to the contract market, including large hotel groups and small family-run business. No matter how large or how small your order, you will always get that personal service from our sales team. Come along and visit our showroom.
The Warrington Irish Club, 83 Orford Lane, Warrington. a friendly and welcoming club keeping the Irish culture alive. We have Irish and country music every Saturday night, tribute nights, race nights, charity nights and karaoke. All live sports shown on the big screens. We have snooker, dominoes and Crown Green bowling teams along with arts and crafts. Pop in for a friendly welcome and to book your event at the Warrington Irish Club, give Frank a call.
Lolla Vita is an award-winning, independently run Italian restaurant. Located on Rose Lane in the heart of Liverpool, real Italian-style dishes, using the best ingredients, skillfully prepared by our chefs. Come and try our serious Italian experience.
Buckhurst Plant Hire, operating nationwide and supplying equipment to the construction, civil engineering and utility industries. Buckhurst is synonymous with quality equipment and excellent service. Call us today.
IJK's Scrap Metal, Manchester. We provide payment for scrap metal, removal and disposal of cars and abandoned vehicles, a weighbridge facility, authorised treatment facility, recycling and waste management. Full compliance with all legal requirements. IJK Scrap Metal, Manchester, a friendly, professional and reliable service.
Eurogold is driven by being the best civil engineering contractor in the Northwest, ensuring its clients are given the highest level of service that they deserve. Eurogold work in a wide range of industry sectors, including house building, highways, commercial and industrial build.
Welcome back. Now, haemochromatosis is a complaint that affects a lot of people in their everyday lives. Well, recently we went along to speak to Dr. Rachel Brown at Trafford General Hospital in Greater Manchester to find out a little bit more about it.
Haemochromatosis is an inherited disorder that's very common in people of Northern European ancestry, particularly those of Celtic origin, so the Irish and the Scots. It means that patients absorb too much iron from the diet and absorb it when they shouldn't do. So they're at risk of iron overload, which can be a problem as patients get older. Some patients could be asymptomatic, you know, they might not have any symptoms and it might be picked up by their GP doing other tests. But things to look out for would be chronic fatigue. That's a very common one. Some patients can get joint pains, particularly in the small joints in their hands and their feet. It can cause things like diabetes and heart problems and liver problems. So if patients have got anything like that, it's always worth asking the question about haemochromatosis.
Are there any treatments that we can take for haemochromatosis?
Absolutely. So it's bloodletting. We've been doing it for a few hundred years and it works very well for haemochromatosis. So basically we take a pint of blood. The amount that we take is varies on the patient and how they're feeling, and the frequency of how often we take it varies. Some patients need it every week to begin with, others every month, and then generally when they're controlled with their iron levels, it's every 3 to 4 months.
So does haemochromatosis damage our life expectancy?
If it's caught nice and early and managed properly, then no. Patients live an absolutely normal life expectancy. Sadly, if patients sometimes are caught very late and their iron levels are very high, then they're at risk of as I say, the liver problems and the diabetes, and that can sometimes affect how their quality of life can be. So the iron levels that with patients with haemochromatosis, they store more and more and more iron, and that iron needs to be stored somewhere. So it gets stored in the liver, in the heart, in the pancreas, which is an organ, in the tummy, which if it's damaged, it can cause diabetes. and get stored in the joints. That's what causes the joint pains. So patients basically get the symptoms and signs. And if that's left unchecked and the iron levels increase more and more, then that liver can get really damaged and can get cirrhotic, so where the liver is scarred, and that can increase the risk of things like liver cancer. So, but if we catch the disease really early, or early enough that the iron levels aren't too high, we can treat this condition, and it's just a chronic condition where you have to come and see someone like me and have some blood taken off. A lot of patients will come to the hospital for the blood to be taken in either a medical day unit or a haematology day unit, depending on who's looking after them. The appointment's generally for about an hour by the time they've had the blood taken off, and then they always get a cup of tea and some biscuits afterwards to make sure they feel okay. Some patients are allowed to give their blood to the blood service if they're well otherwise and they're happy to do so and their iron levels aren't too high. Patients with haemochromatosis, their blood is brilliant as donator's blood because it's full of iron. So we kind of encourage patients who are well enough and don't have any other medical problems to give blood that way if they can.
Beatrice, we saw you giving some blood there now. Did that hurt?
Not really, no. No. I'm used to it now.
How did you discover that you had haemochromatosis?
When I was working, I used to get very tired and went to the doctors. And she couldn't sort out why I was getting so tired. So they sent me to this hospital and it was quite high. The doctor said I was lucky that I didn't have any organ damage, because it attacks your major organs. So I've been coming here now for 15 years.
And you just come to have your blood drained every so often?
Yes, every 3 months. I used to come every month when I started first, because it was a high to get rid of the iron, but now it's every 3 months.
And tell me a little bit about your Irish heritage and your background.
Well, I come from a little village in County Kilkenny called Inistig.
Yeah.
I left there when I was 16. I come over here. I still got my brother in Inistig. I went back last year. It was his son's wedding, which was my nephew. And we had a really good time.
Back in 1986, I'd moved over from Ireland to the UK, and then within 12 months, I was suffering with horrific mouth ulcers. And after putting up with them for a while, I went to my GP, and he suggested that I take some steroids, which I did. But the minute I stopped the steroids, the mouth ulcers came back. So after months of doing various kind of treatments, going to see an oral surgeon, and said there was no problem orally, obviously because I attend a dentist on a regular basis. But then they sent me for a blood test, and it came back that my ferritin levels, which measures iron in the body, were very, very high. And fortunately, they sent me then to a haematologist who diagnosed me with haemochromatosis. But before being diagnosed, I didn't know what was going wrong. I was suffering chronic fatigue, and I mean going to bed early and getting up at a reasonable time, you know, 8 o'clock, and I felt I had never been to bed all night.
What treatment did you have, or what treatment are you still having?
It's like being a blood donor, going to the blood bank and they're having blood removed from you. In the beginning, when I was diagnosed, I was going every week for 18 months. And then as the iron levels were coming down, the change then onto it went every fortnight, every 3 weeks. And eventually, after probably about 3 years, I went on to every 3 monthly. Unfortunately, because of the gene that I carry, which is the C2A2Y, which is the main HFE gene for haemochromatosis, I carry two of them, so I load pretty quickly. And at the moment, I'm going back between 6 and 8 weeks to have a unit of blood taken out of me at my local hospital.
So how do you feel when you've taken when the blood has been taken out?
Certainly within 48 hours, I feel like a new woman. Before that, I can tell, and even, you know, family members can tell that I need to be bloodlet because my mood changes and I could argue with myself. And I don't really know what is going on, but I do feel terribly tired. And going to bed and getting up in the morning time, I feel as if I haven't slept all night, even though I know I've had a few hours, but I feel that I just haven't been to bed at all.
Now, tell me a little bit about your Blackpool support group, because I know you're heavily involved in all this.
Yes, we set that up in 2014. I had spent some time with the Northwest group before then, and they were covering areas like Merseyside, Warrington and Manchester. But we knew at that stage there was a lot of people up kind of Lancaster, even in the Blackpool, Preston areas, Morecambe, where a lot of Irish had moved into. So we knew that there was a lot of people there with haemochromatosis because of knowing there was a lot of Irish people living there. And that's why we set up a group there, because they weren't travelling to meetings, and that's why we decided it was best to have something near for them to attend rather than them travelling to Warrington or Manchester. Just recently, we have a PowerPoint presentation which we've done for many years, but just recently the pathology lab at Preston Royal asked us to come and give them our presentation, because the people there, all the staff, take the blood from people and they never know what happens to the people afterwards. All they know is they've got haemochromatosis, but they haven't actually seen anybody with haemochromatosis, and to understand the side effects of what they have, because liver is one of the worst problems that people can have when it's undiagnosed. They can end up with cirrhosis of the liver, and sometimes people will think, oh well, there must be a big drinker, when in fact they might take very little alcohol. Joint pain in any joint in the, it can be hands, your knees, your neck, your feet, anywhere you can have joint pain, which can be caused by haemochromatosis. It affects 1 in 200 people in the UK, and 1 in 8 are carriers. It affects 1 in 83 of Irish people, and 1 in 4 are carriers. And another thing I would like to just say is that people who are carriers of the gene can still load iron, even though they will tell you that they don't, but I know several people who have one copy of the CA2Y and one of the H63D gene, which people will understand, they can still load iron.
How can people come along to one of your sessions and find out a little bit more?
We do put notifications up about a month or 6 weeks in local hospitals and doctor surgeries, but if they also check our website, I also give the nurses who are taking the blood from us, I give them a little small piece of paper to give to patients when they come in, informing them of when our meetings are going to be. Plus, I also advertise in like the local newspaper, which is like an A5 that comes out that advertisers pay for. They let us advertise in that free, just again to get it out to the people.
We hope that you've learned a little bit more about haemochromatosis, and if you've got any of the symptoms talked about on tonight's show, please contact your GP. Well, that brings us to the end of the show for this week. Don't forget, Henry McGlade is back with his show at 7 o'clock next Thursday evening, and we are here with the Irish in the UK at 7:30. Until then, bye-bye.